it's a geological wonder where we live here.
I went to the place east.
Husband.
Oh, there you are.
Yeah. I know, you've been, your eyes have been really bugging you.
Oh, they are. Indeed they are.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well, you can do, you know, do these practices with your eyes closed, actually.
I thought I can see your features even today.
Oh, good. Marvelous. Well, how do I look?
Not with my new ones, though.
Okay, not with your new glasses. You're looking over the tops of your glasses. Yeah. All right. Well, I'm glad you're here, and I'm glad your eyes are feeling better. And
me too.
RN and Don, it's great to have you guys here.
Thank you.
So arrange your chairs so that you're like the spokes of a wheel, so you don't have to crank your head to see. Yeah, that's perfect. Yeah, good. And today's class, it's Friday, so Mondays we start with a self-massage. In Sanskrit we say abhyanga, and it's for lymphatic massage, and it's top to toe. And then Wednesdays we do follow the Joints and Glands series that my teacher taught, Swami Rama of the Himalayas. And that just systematically goes from the crown of the head to the tips of the toes and really gets into all of the joints of the body. It involves a little massage of the glands, but basically to address the neural pathways that are part of the body. And Fridays, we wrap things up with a solar salutation or solar vitalization practice. And all 3 days really encourage the stimulation of the digestive system from the lips through the esophagus, stomach, intestinal organs, and to the anus. So we look at the these practices, the joints and glands, are designed to stimulate digestion. A good bowel movement is absolutely essential, regularity, consistency. And so digestion is not only the taking in of food and the digestion of it, but the assimilation of it. And it turns out the eyes, the ears, the surfaces of the skin, and the taste, the five senses are involved in the process of taking in food metaphorically and also physically from the world. And we digest it and we either process it or we don't. And that leads to stress factors. So let us begin our class with the centering practice. So this class is going to be arthritis therapy. Therapy for arthritis, typically inflammation, which is caused by excess heat, and also excess heat, which is finding a route for elimination, which is not ideal. So arthritis is an inflammatory condition, a condition produced by heat, which is built up, and which is, instead of getting released through the body's natural elimination processes, is getting stuck in the joints, which are chakras, minor chakras. In yoga, we speak of all of the joints as actual chakras, places of ischemia. Ischemia being the constriction of capillary beds. So joints and glands is all about moving through that and bringing that energy through that so it can be released properly. So let yourself sit as tall as possible. Let your eyes close and come into the feeling sense of the breath flowing into the nostrils, the cool, dry quality of the air as it first comes in the nostrils and flows as one stream from the nostrils into the center of the skull, the region behind the eyes, and from there into the abdomen, into the navel region. Feel the movement of the breath regions of the rib cage, in the lungs, in three dimensions. Simply letting the breath move the body and letting the body be supported by the chair and the floor. Letting the floor and the chair support the body. Exhaling. lowering the ear, opening the neck, shortening the side body on the right side, lengthening on the left, and then you inhale, you come back through center, and you exhale, go the other side, shifting your weight onto that right sit bone and opening the left, the right side of the neck, that is, yeah, and inhale, come back to center, and place your hands on your knees, good. So we went front and back and side to side. And let us do our lion pose, Simha Kriya. So begin by just opening the mouth, stick out the tongue towards the tip of the chin. Now relax. And the next time you do that, open your mouth, stick out your tongue, open your eyes wide and look up through the tops of the eyes. And relax. Close your lips and notice that you have a little increased saliva in your mouth. And just remember that these practices stimulate your saliva, lots of digestive enzymes, the beginning of the digestive process. And now we're going to do that again. And this time, I want you to remember that a cat and a dog in the morning, when they stretch, their ears come back along the sides of their face. They draw the skin back across all of their body towards their tail. So place your hands, palms down, spread your fingers, spread your toes and your shoes, grip the floor, draw your heart forward, your back is long, you're sending your tail down behind you, and this time you're going to pitch forward from the hips on your exhalation in a hissing sound. So first exhale and inhale. Now open your face wide, open your eyes wide, stick out your tongue, and exhale sharply. And then relax and come up slowly so that there is no discomfort and no dizziness. Very good. So we rapidly exhale the air and give a little massage to the diaphragm, to the base of the heart. There are no counter indications for hypertension or glaucoma or detached retinas in this practice. So it's perfectly safe, very good for the digestive system. Okay, once you've returned, let your arms dangle and come into the circles of the shoulders. Make the circles a little bigger, raise them towards your ears, and then slide them down your back. A little higher and down, a little higher and down, good. And then reverse the direction, reverse the direction, yeah, you go. And then seat down, I'll get you a chair. Okay, let your arms come to a restful position and bring your awareness into your fingertips beside your chairs there and begin to make small circles with your fingertips next to your chin. Would you like to sit here? Actually, you're going to do some arm swing, so maybe you can take a little extra space there. Good. So as you make those circles with your hands and wrists next to the chair, gradually the circles become a little larger until you're making arm, hand, and wrist movements coming forward like you're diving, bowing in, and then your arms may come up over your shoulders, but for some of us they don't, so they just come up to shoulder height. It's fine. If you have the range of mobility and you want to take them higher, you can, but it's perfectly all right to just come forward, bend the spine, just like you're diving. And then as you come up and over, like you're holding some soup bowls, so you really take your shoulders onto the back. Good. And one more time, bending in, exhaling, inhaling, yeah. And then catch your breath, it's fine. That's good, yeah, that's good. It's good, it's exercise. And when we lift our arms high like that, it does give us a lot of cardiovascular work. So a little bit goes a long way. And a little bit is, you know, fine to do. So everyone within their capacity, okay. And then come back to your neutral position. And we'll work into our spine. So this is gonna be making large turning motions with your spine. So begin by bringing your heart forward over your right thigh, and then towards me, And then over towards your left, and then round your heart back in towards your chair. And then bring it out towards me again. Yeah, that's good. Good, excellent. Over, yeah, perfect. And then reverse that direction. Today we're doing just a few of these movements just to kind of warm up the joints between our ribs, our cartilage, our rib cage, and down our spine. Yoga is really about the spine, and the arms and legs are kind of just a appendicular skeleton. Okay, all right, come back to center. And sit tall, good. Good, and work with breathing through the nose. It'll help you stay at your pace if you breathe through your nose. You won't feel like working too hard if you have to breathe through your nose, okay? All right, great. And then bring the awareness into the right leg and pick it up. Possible, make some circles with the foot and the ankle. Good, go the opposite direction. Point the toes, just some circling with the lower limb there from the toes to the knee, kind of like a cone shape there. A little bicycling with that leg. And here, this is really an individual thing. You can lift the leg higher and push and pull, or you can just stay down low and take it out to the side to get into that hip. And again, it can go way to the side and then almost cross over. Just so you can, and you stop, you rest. You rest whenever you need to and reverse that direction. Yeah, part of the balance of yoga is matching our desires and our wants with our needs. And that's often the point of stress. We want and we desire, and then our needs are different. So we have to really address those, right? Yeah. Good, I like this, yeah. Extend that right leg, press out through the heel, the sole of the foot, and then make an accelerator out of it, good. And then again, good, great, okay, good. Make a fist with your toes, make it tight, keep breathing. Breath flow, drop on your buttocks as well, so everything's kind of raising you up, good, and then release. Good, again, sort of like drawing up, gathering. You notice that when you draw in your buttocks, you actually sit taller, good. And then release, one more time, draw up. Good, and then release, good, very nice. Draw back on that right leg, and give it a little pummeling from the knee to the hip. You can use your fists, a little karate chopping, and then a little slapping, so you get that smarting quality too. Yeah, good. Not enough to bruise, but you know, you get that satisfying sound to it, and it feels good. Your leg feels really alive. So take a moment to sit tall with your eyes closed. Before we go on, just simply to come back to your full breath awareness. Feel the movement of the breath, and also notice with your awareness, the feeling sense of your right leg and how different it feels from your left.